So Catherine, in our case this morning, we used ice to assess contact. We know when PFA biophysics is discussed, a key topic is the importance of catheter contact with the tissue to optimize PFA's impact. I assume Dr. Koruth had some points to make on that subject.
Yes, he had an interesting lecture on the relationship between the stability of large footprint catheters and lesion stability.
Over the next 10 to 20 minutes, I'm going to take you through pulse field lesion size, the role of electrode placement and contact. These are my disclosures and a special acknowledgement to my postdocs who are responsible for many of the lesion pictures that you'll see in this presentation. To really understand what a PFA lesion is, it's critical to understand the electric field, which, as you can tell from the slide, is very specific to each catheter design. Every electric field is generated by the voltage applied from the PFA generator. I'm going to start off by talking about focal catheters. These are some examples of focal PFA lesion morphologies. You have a focal large tip bipolar lesion here, a focal large tip monopolar lesion here, and focal small tip bipolar and small tip bipolar nanosecond lesions here. And what you see here are different shapes, different morphologies, different signatures. Some of them have a completely homogeneous background. Some of them have a hemorrhagic center. And understanding what these lesions look like and what their dimensions are is how you're going to use this technology to make a lesion set that helps your patients. An important thing that everybody always asks about pulse field is what is the role of contact and proximity? And the way to understand how pulse field is different from thermal ablation, which really depends on contact and duration of stable contact, is that pulse field, because it's ablating using electric field, is not contact or proximity dependent. Meaning, as Howard et al. Show in this nice paper, even with the catheter offset from the tissue, even with the 2 millimeter offset, you still can make a lesion. But remember, when we want to make good lesions in the beating heart, it's very important that we get stable contact because most of our technologies aren't designed to make very large lesions. When we talk about small catheters, such as a 3.5 millimeter tip catheter, there's been a lot of debate about the importance of contact force. There are some papers that say that this is not that relevant, and there are some papers that say that this is relevant. This is work from Dr. Nakagawa, who show that with increasing contact force, both in the right ventricle and in the left ventricle, you have an increase in lesion depth. Now, one peculiar aspect of pulse field ablation compared to radio frequency is, as you increase the contact force, it impacts the depth more than the width as per this particular paper. But I want to take you to a step further and tell you the role of contact force and stability with different types of catheters. This is an example of a small footprint focal catheter. What you are seeing here is a catheter placed into tissue. And as we increase the contact force, the catheter dips into the tissue a little bit. Remember, the 3.5 millimeter small footprint focal catheter is inherently unstable. But when we increase the contact force, we do two things. We compress tissue if the tissue is thick and stiff, or we tend tissue if the tissue is thin. This allows for improved stability and coupling, and that's how contact force seems to be a bigger factor that's relevant for lesion formation with these small footprint catheters. When we talk about large footprint catheters, these catheters are inherently stable. When contact force increases, there's tissue compression and tenting to a certain degree, but what also happens is the tip itself compresses, and that helps with stability and coupling. So contact force may be particularly relevant to try and maximize the lesion with the small footprint catheters. It may be less important with the large footprint focal catheters. Next, we're going to talk about multi-electrode PFA lesion morphologies. What you see here is examples of multi-electrode catheters that deliver PFA. Here you see a pentaspline catheter, and what you see here is with a single application, this is the baseline image of a swine superior vena cava. Right after you deliver a single application without any rotation, you get acute isolation. And this lasts all the way out to 40 minutes, but it's only at 2 days that you see that this vein reconnects. This is what happens with a single application without rotation. Even though you see lesions right over here, there are gaps between these lesions. But with PFA, what's important to appreciate is that even if you have gaps, the phenomena of reversible PFA ensures that during the case, everything turns electrically silent. So understanding what the lesions look like and knowing the importance of rotation is key to ensuring long-term durability. This is an example of a double application. The same phenomena happens: baseline, acute isolation, and then reconnection at 2 days. So if we don't really understand what these lesions look like, we cannot use each catheter judiciously to get durable results. This is an example of the flower pose with the pentaspline catheter. You would think that the lesion morphology looks like a flower, but what we see when we do forceful contact is that the lesion turns into a roughly circular lesion with varying dimensions that are often smaller than the diameter of the catheter. So understanding these footprints and how they differ from the electric field is important to know what percentage overlap you need to ensure durable isolation. These are examples of what happens when these catheters are placed against stiffer tissue where there is less stretch. On top, you see single application footprints, and at the bottom, you see double application. And here you see that the lesions actually look like a flower, but that's because the tissue structure is different. And you can note here that in this particular example, one spline is missing, which tells you one of the weaknesses with fluoroscopic assessment of contact and how with poor contact, you can completely miss a lesion. These examples are important for you to understand what these lesions look like and the importance of rotation, even in the flower pose, to ensure that those underfill areas are completely ablated. So far, what I've said is that lesion quality depends on PFA dose, which is waveform and generator specific. We need to understand the electric field. We need to understand the importance of stable contact and coupling, contact force with smaller footprint catheters, understand the lesion morphology, which may not always reflect the electric field. And these are the ways you can maximize lesion quality for any catheter that you're using in the world of PFA. But there's more to be done when we want to make lesion sets that need to connect to each other. We need to do lesion tracking, which is something that we have done very well over the years with radiofrequency catheters, but it's just as important with PFA. In this next slide, what you're seeing is the EnSite system visualizing a multi-electrode catheter, telling you where the catheter is positioned. This helps with reducing fluoroscopic needs, but also tells you what part of the atrium, what part of the PV antrum is being contacted with tissue. And the future of all of these assessments and projections will be not only visualizing the catheter within a left atrial shell, but also telling you how well each electrode is contacting so that you can make your best lesion. These are some examples to highlight how fluoroscopy doesn't always give you the same insights such as you may get with intracardiac echo. These large multi-electrode catheters often do not have contact force sensing, so it's really important to use some modality to understand contact. And here you can see that the pentaspline catheter in basket pose is in the left superior vein, and you have contact all along here, but these electrodes are free-floating and not going to cause a lesion. Here is another example of the pentaspline catheter in flower pose being pushed against the tissue, and you can see the petals peel back, suggesting that there is good contact. But in different situations, what you see here is that the catheter has prolapsed into the left vein, which is not what you want. And in this situation, the catheter is pushing and folding over the ridge and barely touching the other side. So intracardiac echo, especially for multi-electrode catheters, can be very helpful in understanding contact. This next slide shows you a video loop where we are moving the catheter, and what you see is contact on some splines, how some splines prolapse into the vein, suggesting that's not good contact, and that's the role of using fluoroscopy for certain designs. On the other hand, if you just look at a still image, you have no idea of what contact is going to be. And in this particular case, the left veins are out here and the flower is being held up by the ridge, suggesting that you'll get a very weak lesion. This is another example from work from Dr. Banai in our group, who basically shows us that for three positions where the flower catheter is placed up against the left atrial roof, you get varying footprints. On the left, you see what these lesions look like 1 minute and 5 minutes after PFA. In the top panel, you see a donut-shaped lesion that regresses after 5 minutes. In the middle panel, you see a vague lesion at 1 minute, but almost all of that lesion regresses in 5 minutes. And in the bottom panel, you see a pretty good consistent lesion. Now remember, these are single applications, but what they are highlighting to us is that fluoroscopy alone will not be the answer to get perfect contact and perfect lesions.
Yes, he's right. Contact is important. Large footprint catheters inherently demonstrate more stable contact than small footprint catheters. Acute isolation may occur in each case, but may not be as durable with a small footprint catheter.